So I introduce myself. I am Rangarao from Mechanical Department. I am taking this certificate called Fundamentals of Management for Engineers for this semester. So today I am going to explain about the what are the importance of management for engineering students. That is called introduction part. So I will first explain what is the course objectives and course outcomes for this course. So, what is the purpose of this course, and we'll explain in the next slide. First one is to understand the management concepts. Then, application of concepts or practical aspects of business. Then, development of managerial skills for engineers. And the fourth one is understand the concepts of operation management and marketing management. And fifth one is understand the various tools of project management techniques. So these are all the course objectives. First one is to understand the management concepts, application of practical aspects of business, development of managerial skills for engineers, then understand the concepts of operation management and marketing management. And the last one is understand is project management techniques. Okay. Then now, what is the outcome of this course? So once you gone through the syllabus, then after the completion of your syllabus, you can, these are all the course objectives. So first one is significance of management in their profession. And the second one is understand the various managerial functions like planning, organizing, staffing and leading and controlling. Then third one is students are understand the various production systems. And the fourth one is students can acquire the knowledge of marketing including digital marketing, which is emerging area. And the last one is students can understand the project management functions. So these are all the outcome of your course. Okay, so as per J2 syllabus, these are all the 5 units as usual. So first unit deals with the introduction to management, and the second unit deals with the organization structure and the HRM. HRM is human resource management, and third one is the operation management, the fourth one is the marketing management, and fifth one is project management. So these are all the 5 units. And as usual, these 2.5 are first unit and last 2.5 for the segment. So before going for your course, first you have to understand what is meant by a management. So what is the definition of management, and what is the evaluation of management theory, and what are the functions of management, and what is the role of manager, and what are the challenges faced by manager. We are going one by one. Okay, first you have to go to the definition of management. So management is an act of getting people together to accomplish desired goals and objectives using available resources efficiently and effectively. What means efficiently and effectively? Management is the act of getting people together to accomplish design goals and objectives using available resources. Okay, so resources are men, material and equipment are various resources. So we have to effectively and efficiently make use of these resources. That is called a management skills. So the role of manager is effectively manage these resources. And according to the Peter Drucker, which is one of the management guru, is defined, management is a multi-purpose organ that manages business and manages workers and work. So the management of people and functions, he has defined by Peter Drucker. Okay. And one more is management comprising of planning, organizing, staffing, leading and controlling. Okay, planning, organizing, staffing, leading, coordinating and controlling. So these are all called functions of management. One is planning, organizing, staffing, leading, coordinating and controlling. The organization is called functions of the management. Okay. So here you can see these are all the various stages where the management have been evolved over a period of time. Okay. So one is called a neoclassical theory, that is called a human relationship approach. And second one is behavioral science. And third one is management science or operational research. And fourth one is the modern management. So these are all the various stages of evolution of a management over a period of time. Okay. The first one is the classical theory, which is between 1920 to 1950. And behavior theory, one of the important is McGregor and Abraham Maslow, where motivation and human needs are very much important in the management. So they have called a behavioral approach. So after that, after Second World War, these management science OR is coming to the center stage, where you can make use of mathematical models for optimization of the resources. That is called management science or OR, called operational research. Okay, and third, last one is the modern management tools. The modern management tools deals with one is called just-in-time manufacturing, another is called business process re-engineering, then another is called total quality management. These are all the modern management tools. Okay. So here, so just now we have discussed about the evaluation of the management. The first one is Henri Fayard, which is a French scientist. He has evolved 14 principles of management. Then after that, F.W. Tyler has introduced the scientific theory of management. And the next one is Elton Mayo and introduced motivation theory. And the last one is the system approach. So he is one of the pioneer. He is basically a mining engineer and a management degree. He is a French national. So his education is graduated from mining academy, and he is founded a mining company, and he established various contribution called 14 management principles. So what are the principles? You can see here. So these are all the 14 principles of management, which are still we are using. So this is developed by Fayard in 1800s. And one is called division of work. The first one is called the division of work. So the work can be divided into a number of parts called a division of work, where the specialization is coming to picture. And third one is authority and responsibility. So when you do a management job, somebody has to give a authority. Authority is they have to give the orders, called authority. So responsibility is what the orders has to obey is called responsibility. And third one is the discipline. Discipline in the sense we have to follow the rules and regulations called discipline. And the fourth one is unity of command. There the orders has to be passed from one line up to another is called that is called unity of command and unity of direction, where the orders can be coming from top to bottom or bottom to top. Then the subordination of individual interest to common good. That means the company interest is important than the individual interest. Then the remuneration. So each one has to pay what they are worked with. Then the centralization, where the authority can be laid down and the scalar chain. Order, equity and stability, initiation, asperity, decops. Asperity, decops is called team spirits. So these are all the 14 principles which are developed by Henri Fayard. Okay. Yes. So these are all the important aspect of one is called F.W. Tyler, which is contributed to scientific management. So he is American mechanical engineer, and you can see from apprentice machinist to the engineers, and he has developed many called principles of scientific management. So one is called time study. So introduced one of the concept called time study, where individual work can be measured by using a stopwatch called time study, where the workers can be given the remuneration for the what they have worked for the time. Okay, that is the contribution of the WTI. Okay, so these are all the some of the modern terminology which are used as of now today. One is called just-in-time manufacturing, second one is the lean manufacturing, and third one is the Kaizen, and fourth one is the Six Sigma. So these are all the latest management practice where you can have. One is called just-in-time, where whenever you want the material, you can get the material. That is basically, this is a waste elimination process which is developed by Toyota Production System in 1945. Still we are using, where you can eliminate the waste issues. And lean is where you can improve the production and reduce the cost. That is called lean. Lean and just-in-time, which are introduced in Japan in Toyota Production System. And the Kaizen is nothing but a continuous improvement, where the improvements can be improved over a period of time, and it should be a continuous. And the last one is the Six Sigma. Six Sigma is nothing but where 99.99% of the products has to be accepted. That is called a quality level. So when you take the normal distribution curve, the area under the curve will represent the 99.9 acceptable length. That is called Six Sigma. So Six Sigma is one of the parameters where you can use the quality measurements. Okay. So that is about the what are the various stages of evaluation of management. Then we will go to the what are the principles of management. So we will go one by one. So basically, these are all the principles of management or functions of management. One is called planning, and the second one is organizing. Third one is the staffing, fourth one is directing, and the last one is control. Okay, we will go one by one. So, what is a planning? Okay, planning is a process by which managers establish goals and define the methods by which these goals are to be attained. Okay, so planning is important in any activity. For example, if you see your classwork is planning is necessary for preparation of the timetable for the next academic year. That is called a planning. Okay? So when you are talking about the planning, preparation of the examination also is planning. So all these called a planning activity. That is, planning is the process by which managers establish goals and define the methods by which these goals are to be attained. So the planning can be either short term or a long term. So for the long term means, if you see the metro project, that is called a long term project. And the short term means when you want some capital requirement of 1 month, that is called short term. So both short term and long term planning is necessary for any organization. And what is the importance of planning? So it will increase the efficiency and reduce the business risk and provides direction to the business. First one is increase the efficiency, reduce business risk, and provides direction to the business. Another is encourages creativity and innovation, helps in decision making. The last one is helps to achieve the objectives. Okay, so these are all the importance of planning. First one is increase efficiency, reduce business related risk, provides direction to the business, encourages creativity and innovation, helps in decision making, helps to achieve objectives. So organizing, okay? So we have to organize the people. So how to organize the people is one of the part, okay? So organization is the process of assembling and assigning the human, financial, physical, informational, and other resources needed to achieve goals. So organization. Okay?
Thank you.
Organization is nothing but organizing the process of assembling and assigning the human, financial, physical, information, and other resources needed to achieve the goals. In today's class, so I will continue in the next class.
Next session.
For the remaining topics. Okay, thank you.